RCIA classes will be starting in the near future. For more information, contact Deacon Barney Lejeune. His contact information is in the bulletin. Please keep in mind that the Year of St. Joseph brochures are still available at the entrances to the church. The mass attention is for today. Joseph and Dolores Coleman, Mark Corner, Anita and Jules Domain, the Rabelais family, Arash Dupre, Ann and Elaine Hamilton, David Morehouse, Ken Cathy, Paul Domain, Sidney Stu, Kenneth and Missy Hicks, Gil Weimer, Lou Lawson, Thorno Zane Nam Nguyen, Maria Nam Ding, Angel Michard, and Barbara Digatina. Our celebrant today is, celebrant today is Father Blake Dubroc. resplendent and unfading as wisdom, and she is readily perceived by those who love her, and found by those who seek her. She hastens to make herself known in anticipation of their desire. Whoever watches for Red Dawn shall not be disappointed, for he shall find her sitting by his gate. For taking thought of wisdom is the perfection of prudence, and whoever for her sake keeps vigil shall quickly be free from care, because she makes her own rounds, seeking those worthy of her, and graciously appears to them in the ways, and meets them with all solicitude. The word of the Lord. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God.
O God, you are my God whom I seek. For you my flesh pines and my soul thirsts, like the earth parched, lifeless, and without water.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God.
Thus have I gazed toward you in the sanctuary to seek your power and your glory. For your kindness is a greater good than life. My lips shall glorify you.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord my God.
Thus will I bless you while I live. Lifting up my hands, I will call upon your name. As with the riches of a banquet shall my soul be satisfied, and with exalted lips my mouth shall praise you. I will remember you upon my couch, and throughout the night watches, I will meditate on you. You are my help, and in the song of your wings, I shout for joy.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the triumph of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words.
you and I become in a dark place, which we don't know what this place is going to be or what our country is going to be like in the next 4 years, but it could get darker for the church in some capacity. That means we must inflame the faith by our works, by our deeds. Our doing points to our being, and our being is that we were baptized into that light. Right after this matter, we have baptism. The Easter candle has been lit. The Easter candle we use the baptism, we take the light and we hand it on to those and says, keep the light of faith. That same Easter candle that walked into this church in pitch dark on the Easter vigil. Because we are part of that light, we've been baptized into that light, and we must share, continue to share that light. And so for the child who's baptized, the only way he or she is going to be active or activate that flame that's been given to her is to live out the faith with our deeds. My actions, certainly if I was bandaging up someone or opening someone on the operating table, my actions would reveal my identity as a doctor. If I was caring for children, I was supplying food for them, I was loving on them, I was making sure they were guided and teach and taught and making sure they had a roof over their head, my actions would point to my father or that I was a parent. Our actions, do they point to our Christian identity? St. James says, so faith by itself, if it has no works, is dead. But someone will say to you, you have faith and I have works. Show me your faith without works, and by my works I will show you my faith. Wasn't our ancestor Abraham justified by works when he offered his son Isaac on the altar? You see that the faith was active along with his works, and faith was brought to completion by works. At the end of the parable, Jesus explains that the bridegroom will not claim to recognize us just because we say, no, no, I was with him. I was with the church. Unless you show the light, unless you let the flame continue to grow in you by your acts, by your deeds, and by your prayer, our Lord may say to us, I do not know you. So we come here, and I think that you're here because you want to know Jesus Christ. That's why you're here. Your presence here is an expression of your faith. I'm no more San Diego Padre because I put on a uniform than I am a Christian if I just say I am. Let our faith come alive by our works, and let us surrender to him who comes on the altar and feeds us himself. You and I have been claimed by him. We love him. We adore him. And so we ask him to continue to bless us and inflame the fire of our faith. Thank you.
to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For an increase in vocation to the priesthood, religious life, and consecrated life in this parish and from our diocese, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
God, our Creator, who bless us and bestow your blessings upon us. We thank you for hearing us, and we ask you to continue to hear us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise of the Lord in his name, for the glory of the gospel of the church.
Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, upon the sacrificial gifts offered here, that celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. mystery of faith. We proclaim
your death.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we were nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with the Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Douglas, our Bishop, the Archbishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, to whom you must still in the world, all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Savior's command formed by divine teaching, we dare to say.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God,
you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace.
Thank you. pray.